Let's talk about communication that happens through the computer. This is called CMC, or computer-mediated communication. Some examples are Yahoo Messenger, Windows Live Messenger. Those are examples of instant messaging. Skype is virtually the same thing, but it likes to promote itself as voice over IP, or VoIP technology. If you haven't tried one of these, I encourage you to use this class as an opportunity. I have provided my IDs in the syllabus. Another example is any chat site that you might use. Chat allows conversation with multiple people, although IMs now usually allow groups also. Another site or kind of site that is new is called Illuminate. Illuminate's one example. DimDim is another example. And they allow synchronous classes online. So if I need to do any troubleshooting with you online, I may very well ask you to go through the Illuminate website. Illuminate allows the teacher to have verbal and textual conversations with students. It also allows the instructor to take control of the student's computer, plus some other features. One last kind of CMC are virtual worlds, with the most famous one being Second Life. I'm not good at Second Life. While IMing and chatting are mostly writing, it's important to know that they do not promote writing fluency. They promote speaking fluency. For some reason, even if you are only communicating through typing and not a webcam or microphone, the part of your brain that gets activated is what we use for listening and speaking, not reading and writing. So if you try using them in class, I suggest you be careful about rules regarding punctuation and capitalization and full sentences, because that will be forcing a skill upon a technology that doesn't fit, in my opinion. On the other hand, definitely impose rules and guidelines for writing in emails and discussion boards. In fact, you might want to have the students practice writing the same email to people of different status. We talk differently, even in email, to our boss as compared to our friend. Okay, let me finish talking about reading and writing and technology by going back to the earliest and most obvious use, that of word processing. In class, we're using Google Docs to do some word processing. We also will use Microsoft Word and PowerPoint, but if you can't afford copies of those at home, you can download OpenOffice from the internet. It contains several free programs that do the same thing Microsoft Office does. It might be good to remember it in case you have a student sometime that can't afford their own MS Office software. Anyway, it's important to teach students the basics of how to use a word processing program. For example, they shouldn't use the space key 5 times at the beginning of a paragraph. Instead, they should hit the tab key 1 time to create the indented first line. Also, as they are typing, they should understand about word wrap. Word wrap means that you do not have to hit enter at the end of one line. Just keep typing and the software will wrap itself and start a new line. You only use the enter key at the end of a paragraph. Otherwise, you are creating extra work for yourself if you try to go back and make any changes. It's also good to understand about line spacing, so single space versus double space lines, how to set or change the margins, and what the difference is between save and save as. Save as creates a copy of the document, while save keeps replacing the same document. Some other skills to teach are copy, paste, insert, bold, underline, italics, center alignment, left alignment, and how to change font sizes. Of course, this is all more fun when you teach some non-essential skills also, like how to change the font color or insert pictures. So, using technology to help students improve their reading and writing, grammar, and vocabulary is really easy. Just take your pick of one of the techniques and try it out.